Hello viewers, welcome to JSM. In this lecture, we are going to discuss previous NEET questions solutions from D and F block elements. In that one, magnetic moment and magnetic behavior related questions we are going to discuss, because that is very important. So many times questions are asked. So in this lecture, how to solve those questions easily, that we will discuss, right? So look at the first one. Magnetic moment 2.83 Bohr magneton is given by which of the following ions? Okay, magnetic moment is given and we have to identify which ion has this magnetic moment. Okay, so let us see here, what is the formula to calculate magnetic moment? Magnetic moment, it is denoted by mu, right? Okay, magnetic moment mu is equal to square root of n into n plus 2 Bohr magneton. Okay, so this formula very important, square root of n into n plus 2 Bohr magneton. Okay, see here, in this one, what is n? N is nothing but number of unpaired electrons. Number of unpaired electrons. Okay, so n is the number of unpaired electrons. So here already mu is provided in the problem, right? So that is 2.83 Bohr magneton is equal to square root of n into n plus 2 Bohr magneton. If we solve this one, we get n is equal to 2. So how many unpaired electrons are there? 2 unpaired electrons are present. Okay, so see here, 2 into 2 plus 2, 2 plus 2 is how much? 4, 4 into 2 is 8, square root of 8 we get. So that is nothing but 2.83. So that's why from like that n is equal to 2. Okay, so here now we have to identify in which of the given ion 2 unpaired electrons are present, that we have to identify. Okay, let us see this one. Titanium plus 3, its atomic number is 22. See, if you consider the neutral titanium atom, okay, argon 4s2 3d2, this is the valency electron configuration for titanium. See here, 3 electrons are removed, yes or no? Plus 3 means 3 electrons are removed from the neutral titanium, but we know that. So 2 electrons, we should remove electrons from the s orbital. After that, remaining electrons we should remove from the d. Okay, why? This is the valency shell orbital and this is the penultimate shell orbital, right? So here 2 electrons plus 1 more. So overall, what is the configuration here? 3d1 we get. Okay, only I am writing d orbital, because see here, this n is number of unpaired electrons of d orbitals. Okay, in d orbital. So here 3d1, only one unpaired electron is present. So this is not answer. Next here, nickel. Neutral nickel electronic configuration is argon 4s2 3d8. 4s2 3d8. See here, if we remove 2 electrons from the s orbital and its configuration is 3d8. Okay, so now if you write this one, this configuration in the box notation, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. See, we have 2 unpaired electrons. So that's why nickel plus 2 has this magnetic moment, okay, because of presence of 2 electrons. See here, chromium plus 3, what is the configuration for chromium? Argon 4s1 3d5. Okay, so if you remove 3 electrons, 1 from s orbital, 2 from the d orbital, here we get 3d3. So 3 unpaired electrons. So this is also not answer. Next, manganese, neutral manganese, argon 4s2 3d5. Okay, so if you remove 2 electrons from the s orbital remaining, for Mn plus 2, what is the configuration? 3d5. So we have 5 unpaired electrons. So that's why, what is the answer? Nickel plus 2 is the answer, because it has 2 unpaired electrons. If we substitute in this formula, we get 2.83. Okay, clear. So in this, whatever the ion given, remember this formula very important, and here n is the number of unpaired electrons present in the d orbital. Okay, clear, very important. Sometimes they will ask the ion, which ion has highest magnetic moment, or which of the following is the correct order of magnetic moment, like that. So many types of questions can be asked related to the same formula. Okay, just remember this, then you can answer any type of question. Right, next. See, which of the following lanthanoid ions is diamagnetic? Okay, which of the following lanthanoid ions is diamagnetic? So how can we identify diamagnetic or paramagnetic if there is no single unpaired electron? Okay, diamagnetic, if there is no unpaired electrons are present, then they are diamagnetic. So no, at least one unpaired electron should be present to exhibit paramagnetic behavior. Okay, there is no unpaired electron, then that is diamagnetic. Let us see here. Samarium plus 2 is given here. Okay, so what is the configuration for this samarium plus 2 is that 4F6. Only I am writing F orbital configuration only. Okay, see 4F6. For europium plus 2, 4F7. Okay, ytterbium plus 2, 4F14. Cerium plus 2, 4F2. Okay, see already I have explained in one video how to write these configurations in the plus 2 oxidation state, plus 3 oxidation state in a simple way. I will give the link in the description. Please go through that video if you have any doubt. In a simple way, you can remember these configurations of the lanthanoids and actinoids. Okay, so now here, see this. F6, 6 unpaired electrons are present. F7 configuration, 7 unpaired electrons are present. F14, okay, so this is our answer because there is no unpaired electron, right? See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So 14 electrons, all are spin paired. There is no single unpaired electron is present. Okay, so that's why this is diamagnetic. Okay, remaining these all have unpaired electrons. So that's why they are paramagnetic. Okay, clear? So whatever it is that may be related to the diamagnetic, paramagnetic, what is the concept? Remember here, if there is no unpaired electron is present, all are spin paired, or there is no electron, then they are diamagnetic. If at least one unpaired electron is present, then they are paramagnetic. See, if you consider same type of question also can be asked here also. See here, D1 paramagnetic, one unpaired electron is present. Here two unpaired electrons, paramagnetic. 3, 5, these are also paramagnetic. Okay, just you should check, write the configuration. For d block elements, you should consider the electronic configuration of the d orbital. For f block elements, you should consider the electronic configuration of f orbital. Okay, now let us see another one. Which of the following ions exhibits dd transition and paramagnetism as well? Okay, some ions are given and ask you to identify which has a dd transition and also paramagnetic. So how to answer this type of questions? So first of all, here remember that in this type of questions we should focus on the d block element. Okay, d block element. See here, chromium, and next we have to identify, we should focus on this d block element only, remember that, and identify the oxidation state. So here plus 6, here also chromium plus 6, here MnO4 2 minus, here plus 6, and MnO4 minus, here plus 7. Okay, see, this is a permanganate ion and it is a manganate ion. Permanganate, manganate. So here, after finding this one, what is the d orbital configuration, or how many electrons are present in the d orbital? See here, it has, or I will write like this, you can identify easily, d0 configuration. Okay, chromium plus 6, just now we discussed 4s1 3d5, right? 6 electrons are removed, so we get d0 configuration, and here also chromium has d0 configuration, and here manganese 4s2 3d5, total 7 electrons are there, out of 7 6 are removed, so here we have d1 configuration, and again here D0 configuration. Okay, so in the given ions, chromium has plus 6 oxidation state and D0 configuration. There is no electron present in the d orbital. And here also manganese has a D0 configuration, so here also no electron. And only here in this given ion, manganese has a plus 6 oxidation state and D1 configuration. So this is our answer. Paramagnetism as well as DD transition. Just now we discussed what is the essential condition to show the paramagnetic behavior. At least one unpaired electron should be present. See here, D0, 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 there is no electron present in the d orbital, so that is diamagnetic. And here, only in this given ion, manganese has D1 configuration, one unpaired electron is present. And also, what about this DD transition? Okay, see, generally in the free metal, this 5, these are degenerate orbital. Yes or no? We know that. Okay, but in the excited state or in the presence of ligands or in the compounds, what happens? Okay, that we discuss in detail in the coordination chemistry, also in the CFT. Okay, so here in this 5d orbital, so simply I am explaining here, so just to understand what is a dd transition, this d orbital splits into two sets. Okay, two sets they will split. Okay, this is considered as a T2G set and this is considered as EG set. Okay, we will discuss in detail what is T2G is and all. Right now here, so 5 degenerate orbital splits like this. So now what happens? See here we have the electron, for example. This is the lower energetic d orbitals. These are higher energetic d orbitals. Now this electron excite into this higher energetic d orbital. So means electron is going from one d orbital to another d orbital. That is nothing but dd transition. Okay, see here, there is no electron, means how can dd transition is possible? Not possible. Here we have an electron, so this electron can go from lower energetic d orbital to higher energetic d orbital. So here only DD transition is possible, like this, as well as paramagnetic. Clear? Very, very important this one, right? Next, match the spin magnetic moments of the ions given. So here in column 1 some ions are given and in column 2 they have provided the spin only magnetic moment. Okay, so here now, just now we discussed the formula to calculate magnetic moment. What is the formula? I am writing here, mu is equal to square root of n into n plus 2 Bohr magneton. Okay, so this is the formula to calculate magnetic moment. What is n here? Number of unpaired electrons. Okay, see here, now here in the given ions, we have to identify how many unpaired electrons are present. Then if you substitute in this formula, we get the answer easily. Okay, cobalt 3 plus. See here, for neutral cobalt, what is the configuration? Okay, so argon 4H2 3D7. Okay, 4H2 3D7. But after removing 3 electrons, 2 from s orbital, 1 from d orbital, we get 3D6. Cobalt 3 plus configuration is 3D6. Okay, in the same manner, see here, for the chromium, just now we discussed argon 4s1 3d5. Okay, so here for chromium plus 3 means remove 3 electrons, 1 from s orbital, 2 from d orbital, so here we have 3d3 configuration. Next, here iron. Okay, iron, in the for neutral iron, what is the configuration? Argon 4s2 3d6. Okay, 4s2 3d6. So here if you remove 3 electrons, 2 from here, from 1 from here, we get 3d5 configuration. Okay, and for nickel, okay, for neutral nickel, just now we discussed argon 4s2 3d8. Okay, so here if you remove 2 electrons, then we get 3d8. Okay, right? So here, now, how many unpaired electrons are present?
So here how many unpaid electrons are present? 4 unpaid electrons are present. Okay, 4 unpaid electrons. Next here, 3 unpaid electrons. Here, 5 unpaid electrons. Here, 2 unpaid electrons. Okay, so here, how many unpaid electrons? 2 unpaid electrons. So if you substitute this n value here in this formula, see here, 4. 4 into 4 plus 2. Okay, so I will write here, square root of 4 into 4 plus 2, 6. Okay, so 4 into 6, that is square root of 24. So no, for this cobalt 3 plus. Next here 3. So if you substitute in the formula, 3 into 3 plus 2 is how much? 5. So square root of 15 we get. So no, I am substituting this value in this formula. Next here, for iron plus 3, 5. So square root of 5 into 5 plus 2, 7. So square root of 35. Okay, next nickel, 2 unpaid electrons, right? So that is for nickel, 2 into 2 plus 2, 4. That is square root of 8. Okay, so now cobalt 3 plus square root of 24, where we have fourth one. See, for A, 4 is the matching option. And here for chromium 3 plus square root of 15, this 5 is the matching. For iron 3 plus 5 unpaid electrons, square root of 35. Okay, where we have second one. Next for nickel, square root of 8, first one. So what is the answer, correct answer? So first option is the correct answer. Clear? So whatever it is the question, however it can be asked, see everything is linked to this one, yes or no? So this is the formula we have to remember, very important. And so in this way, if you are able to write the configuration of that ion, then you can easily identify how many unpaid electrons are present. Okay, so I have explained in one video how to remember the electronic configuration of d block elements easily. Okay, I will give the link of that video in the description also. Okay, go through that one if you have any doubts or if you facing problems to remember the electronic configurations of d block elements. Okay, thank you for watching.